everybody, how's it going? It's a Daily Shooter, and today I'm going to be doing a review of the NiteCore MH27 flashlight and the GM04 shotgun mount. Now, this flashlight isn't just your standard white flashlight, it's actually capable of red, green, blue, and white light. It's rechargeable, it uses either one 18650 or two CR123s, and it's capable of 1000 lumens. So let's go ahead and take a look. Now, I've reviewed quite a few flashlights over the years, and after a while, they all start to kind of look the same. They offer the same strobe capabilities, low, medium, high modes, and they're all moderately durable. So it really does take something that sets a flashlight apart in order to catch my eye, whether or not it's the extreme quality or the value, extreme beam distance, or the features that it offers, really for it to stand out to me after a while. And this one really does stand out to me in a lot of different ways. This has a lot of capabilities and a lot of different features. You can see right there, it has a micro USB port, so you can charge the flashlight directly without taking the battery out or requiring a secondary battery charger. Now, this flashlight is extremely durable. It's all weatherproof, so it's a really good, tough design. And I think a lot of people really trust NiteCore as a product. You can see there, it's pretty dirty. I've been using this flashlight for a while now. And as you saw from the intro, I've actually been using it on a shotgun as well. Now, the one capability that really kind of caught me off guard when I first got this flashlight was the fact that not only does it do white light with the standard low, medium, high, and strobe, but it offers a red, green, and blue LED in the same flashlight as well. So you have night capabilities, you have reading capabilities, you have blood tracking capabilities, all out of the same flashlight. So you can see right there inside the bezel, you have your standard white Cree HIL-V3 LED. In the center, and you also have three different colors on the outside, red, green, and blue, that can be used for different things, but all contained within one rechargeable watertight package. So this is something that definitely catches your eye when you're used to a lot of the same when it comes to flashlights. Now, one of the things that caught my attention about the MH27 before I even started using it is the fact that it's a small, single-hand operated flashlight that actually has a little bit of weight behind it, which is something that I like. In an era where everything is becoming ultra lightweight and super thin, this actually feels like you're carrying a flashlight that can take a beating. You can see how thick the crenulated bezel is right there, and it's a really robust design. So I like how they made this a little bit heavier, a little bit thicker. It feels like you're gonna hold something that's gonna last. Now, before we get to the testing, we'll take a quick look at the packaging and what comes inside the box. Now, keep in mind, for the purposes of my review, I did not install the pocket clip, but it does come with a pocket clip. Now, you have your owner's manual here, and this is one manual I actually suggest that you read, because this flashlight has so many functions and so many capabilities that there's a little bit more to it, and I suggest you at least give this a quick once over to kind of understand what it's capable of. You also have a sheath. It's pretty much just a standard sheath, has a Velcro opening on it, and it has a D-ring on the back as well as some extra Velcro. It's kind of a blow-through design, so you put the flashlight in, hangs out at the bottom right there. You can see our D-ring at the top, and then Velcro backing it in the rear. And it's a little bit too wide for MOLLE strapping, so be ready for that. If you want to strap through MOLLE, you do have to bend it a little bit. We have our lanyard and some other pieces. You can see the pocket clip right there. It does come with the extra O-ring and tail cap as well. Now, I took this flashlight out on several shooting trips, and I have it mounted to my Remington 870 12 gauge using their GM04 mount. Now, when I originally got this mount sent to me, I knew it wasn't going to fit the barrel perfectly. I had to use a little bit of duct tape in order to get it on correctly, but I thought it was good for testing the flashlight, see if it could withstand the recoil of a 12 gauge shotgun. And I was really impressed. The light stayed on the entire time. You don't see any type of flickering. You're still able to reach the controls, even though I don't think it's a perfect light for a tactical application due to the fact there's just too many buttons and too many modes. I like a simple on-off flashlight for a shotgun or a rifle. If this is something that you have access to and you need to mount it, I think it's a good option. It definitely provides enough light in order to illuminate your target and able to acquire target acquisition. So that is something that I liked about it. It's a good 1,000 lumens. You could reach out far. If you're shooting with a shotgun, obviously you're going to be probably within 100 yards, but still you can identify a target past 100 yards. Now here you can see that we're using the red, blue, and green functions, as well as the low, medium, high, and strobe. Now, red is good if you're going to be doing some reading or you need low light conditions. Green is good, again, for reading maps and different things like that in low light conditions. And blue is good for, let's say, blood tracking, all of which have a lot of different functions to it. Now, one thing that I really liked about this flashlight is the fact that it uses one 18650 or two CR123s. and really has a pretty good beam distance, over 400 meters beam distance on 118650 at 1000 lumens. So it did provide plenty of light. So if you're looking for something that isn't going to really break the bank and you still get that good, you know, 400 meter plus beam distance, this is definitely something that might work out well for you. Now, you get a good flood, you get a decent spill, you get a good hotspot. It's not a super highly focused hotspot, but it is a good hotspot, and I'll put it on the fence here so you can see. And the LEDs that surround that don't really seem to interfere with that at all. Even though they do take away a little bit of that reflective surface, I don't notice it when I'm shining it on things. You can see low right there is still very usable. And you can see that when we use the other functions, so the red, the green, and the blue, it is a little bit distorted. There's no good circular hotspot or no specific spot that you can look into. It's just kind of a blob, but it's a very usable blob and definitely something that I find a good feature. Now, the NiteCore GM04 gun mount that I was using in the test video is fairly inexpensive. I've seen it around for under $10, and it held the flashlight pretty well to the shotgun, even though it didn't fit, and I knew that prior to getting it. But still, if it will fit on your barrel, and they'll have a list of specific barrels that it'll fit on, it's 25 millimeters. If it'll fit on your barrel, it definitely holds the flashlight secure, and it holds it secure to the barrel and has a lot of contact points on it. So that's a very nice option for a little bit of money, under 10 bucks, like I said, on some websites. And the flashlight itself is great. The MH27 is capable of high lumens using one or two different types of batteries. And it has a rechargeable port in it. So you don't need to worry about buying a secondary battery charger if you're going to buy this flashlight. It's fantastic that you can charge it directly on that. Being the fact that it's micro USB, you can charge it in the car. You can charge it while you're away. You can charge it with solar panels. So that adds to the versatility of the flashlight. As well as obviously the red, green, and blue, which I think would benefit people that are hunters more than anything else, especially with that blue being able to track blood. So a really cool flashlight, definitely worth the investment. It's robust, it's heavy, it's got a lot of great features, guys. Check it out. This is the MH27 by NiteCore. Thank you all very much for watching. Please like, subscribe. Have a great day.